My name is Christopher DiRaddo, and I'm the author of The Geography of Pluto, which is out now from Cormorant Books. I've been writing this book for about 14 years. It's taken a long time, and I've written in a lot of different places over those 14 years. I think I've had at least three different addresses. I've worked at it at my parents' place. I work at it at coffee shops. There was a big part of it that I spent writing at the Bibliothèque Nationale on Berry Street, which is really beautiful. There's this archive area in the back, which you actually have to check your bag and your coat, and you can kind of go in, and it's so beautiful and so quiet. I got a lot of the editing done there. But this is my office. I really do enjoy it. I have this old desk here, which is a teacher's desk, an old teacher's desk that my boyfriend refinished, and I really do love it. It's got a lot of character. And I've spent a lot of time working on this. This is also probably the third laptop that I've had for this book as well over the course of 14 years. And really, I'm one of these writers that's not very faithful to where they work. I think the thing that I'm most faithful to is probably the laptop, because I can just take it anywhere, and if inspiration hits, I can write. This office, as you see, is also it's a salon double, which leads out onto Christophe Colomb, which is quite noisy at times. And there's also a television in the other room, so if my partner is watching TV, it can be a little bit distracting, so that way I'll take the laptop and I'll go into the kitchen, or I'll go into a nice little area of the dining room that looks off onto the outdoors into my backyard and get inspired by the view. The book began as scribblings on cocktail napkins made in a bunch of bars along St. Catherine Street East. The main character of my story is a young gay man, and a lot of the action happens in the 1990s when Montreal's gay village was really a hotbed of nightlife. I guess it still is, but it really hasn't matched the time that it did back then. And I was really inspired by what I saw, and I began to write about what I saw. And around in the mid-90s, I decided to do something with some of the stuff that I'd been writing about, and I sat back and went through, and I found that there was a bit of a story in with what I was writing. And I just started to write. I didn't really know what the story was. I didn't really know where I wanted to go. The way that I see it is almost like making pottery. It's like at the beginning was a lot of throwing the clay onto the spinning platform and just throwing the clay, letting it spin and spin, and then molding it, and figuring out what the shape would be, and then trimming off the sides, trimming off the edges, until you're left with a really beautiful face, which is what I think my book is right now. I'm very proud of it. It's exactly the book that I wanted to write.